I've been working on making a doily. My first attempt here with this acrylic yarn, as you can see, it's curling in on the edges here, but I'm not sure if you could see the lace effect I'm trying to get on there. Then I added these little teeth to the outside, hoping that would help make that stay out. But again, you could see it's curling to the inside. I would have to pull each of these points out, and I did block this. I rarely block my knitted items. But I would have to block it really good, or maybe use some stiffener to keep this to stay out like that. I did drop a stitch at one point, but this was just a sample anyways. Then I used some cotton yarn. And now it's staying flat. I think you could see how it's supposed to go. To me, it looks like little triangles, but you have the little teeth coming out with the lace effect on the outside edge. Now, because this is cotton, you could use this as a washcloth or dishcloth, but I think I'm going to use mine as a doily. I am using the Lion brand kitchen cotton yarn for this. This is a number 4 yarn, and I'm working it on the bulky. If you're using a mid-gauge or standard gauge machine, then you're going to want to use yarn made for those machines. Gauge really is not a factor in this particular project. Now, before I go on, I want to have my counter set to 0 because I work up, and you'll see as I go along, a set of 15 rows. I did waste yarn, a row of ravel cord, and then I started and I got one row of the cotton yarn. Now I'm going to take the left needle here and transfer it one stitch out. I'm going to put that other needle in working position. Now for the bond users, you probably want to have that into holding position just so the yarn goes over it better. Or if you have it in the working position, make sure that latch is open for it to knit properly. Now I'm going to knit back. And here I'm going to put the first needle on the right into holding position. I'm going to knit back to the left. Now this time I'm going to take two needles. Of course, it's always the outside needle. And then I look, I see the eyelet was on 15. So I'm going to take 14, and basically you just look at the eyelets, and you could tell. I should have something written up for this too, and if I do, I'll have a link in the description of the video. And I move those needles to the left. Again, I knit to the right. I bring the next needle out to hold in position, and in time, I'm going to have to move my claw weights up. They really, once I get to the third needle, this claw weight on the right is not going to work properly. Knit back to the left. Now this time I'm taking three needles, and I'm moving each one of those one over to the left again. If you're left-handed, just reverse what I'm doing. You're going to transfer on the right and put the needles on the left into holding position. Because I'm right-handed, I do like it a certain way. Now I knit back to the right. I bring the next needle to hold in position. I knit back. Now here I am going to bind off these three stitches to make that little tooth. Bind off your favorite way. I like to just hand knit those stitches, and I knit them a little bit larger than normal. And then I take my latch tool, go in the first loop on the left here, take it off the hook, go into the next one, push that off the needle, put that second loop through the first loop, and the same for the third loop. And then I hang this on, which is actually left 15. I worked it out so that when I have three gray needles here, I know that I need to bind off. But now I need to continue the lace. So I look, the lace was there, so now I have that one and one more. So it's left 12 to left 13 and left 14 to left 15. And I'm going to have three needles on left 15. I found with this yarn, it doesn't knit properly. So I pull it out to hold in position. And because this carriage will not knit it back, I have to put it into the forward working position. For the bond users, make sure that latch is open. Knit back to the right. Bring the next needle out to hold in position. Knit back to the left. And I repeat. Now I have three needles that I am going to transfer over to the left. Knit to the right. Now I notice my stitches are starting to pop up a little bit there. This is where I need to make sure I put my claw weight up so it's underneath those edge stitches. Knit back to the left. Starting with the outside one, you know you're going to go every other needle. So I just go one needle past that lace. Here I have four needles I'm transferring over. If you have a multi-pronged hole that does every other needle, that would work as excuse me, that would work as well. Like this one here. Now I knit back to the right. Bring the next needle to hold in position. Knit back. I only have two gray ones, so I have to do the lace one more time. This is where I will use my multi-pronged tool. Now if you don't have magnets to pull those needles up, well, this one here ain't going to happen unless I have the magnet. But what I do is I will take and put my hand underneath the work here, and I bring those needles forward just enough to put those latches open. Then I go ahead and take these stitches, and I go back just a little bit more than normal so I don't get mixed up onto what needles I have to go to, and just transfer them over. Again, bringing those empty needles back into working position. Now I'm at my three, but I'm on the lace. So what I want to do is I will bring these needles over here into forward working position. I will then knit two rows. Now I want to bring these needles here in holding position to the forward working position. Or if your carriage is set to hold, just take it off a hold and then knit that. Actually, you got to knit two rows. Because I need to bind off these three stitches again. But I want to do a whole row of lace. That's why those other needles had to be brought back into forward working position. I push those three out of work. Now I go ahead and I just take my every other needle selector, and I will take from the second needle in and push every other needle out. So those are the ones going to be transferred. Now here again is where I will bring those needles forward, and I forgot to mention, push them back. Because that's only six prongs and I have seven needles, I need to do one by itself. Again, that one has three stitches on it, so I'm going to push that back, forward to holding position and back so that stitch is behind the open latch and it'll knit a lot better. Go ahead, push those back, take them off, move them one over to the left. Push those empty needles back. Knit across. Now this is where I want to put my counter back to zero. And where I'm going to be working, starting from row one, I bring the empty needle out. Well, it was row two in the last one, but now this next wedge is going to be pretty much the same with a couple little minor differences. Like here, I'm bringing this needle out to hold in position, knit across, transfer the one needle over. I think what I should do is probably zoom in to just the needle so you could see what I'm doing here. So I take the left stitch, move it over one, knit across to the right, bring the next needle out to hold, and I forgot to move my claw weights up. Knit back to the left, one, skip one, next one, transfer those over to the left. Knit back to the right. Next needle to hold in position. One, two, three. Transfer those stitches over. Again, I see my stitches are starting to come up a little bit, so I move my claw weight up and over. Here I have the three needles of gray. I am going to hand knit those. And when you look at the stitch size here, well, it's hard to see. When you look at the stitch size on these needles, you could see how much bigger to make these. You don't want them too big, but you don't want them really tight because it'll pull it in and that tooth edging will not stick out that well. Push those three needles back. Now when I look at my lace, it was on 15, so 14 and one more. Again, three stitches on that one. I bring it forward and then back into the bring it to holding position and then to forward working position. Then I look again. I have 15, 13, and 11. Now it's 16, 14, 12, and 10. But if you just start on the outside one and do every other needle, look at your lace, and you'll see what stitches have to be transferred over, in my case, to the left. Now I have to left 7 into hold. But I need to get another needle here to make it 3. And because I'm getting close to that, well, let me transfer them first. Pushing them forward, I'm taking that one last needle over there. Because this is 5, this will work out pretty good, this tool. I don't want to go any more on this, so what I'm going to do, because the next time I'm over here, I'm going to bind off those three, I will take these here and put them into the forward working position. Now I'm just going to knit 2 rows. That's one of the differences I was mentioning. Now I'm going to bind off those 3 stitches again. And this is where I'm going to do the every other needle. Transferring over, this is the last wedge, I mean the last row of the wedge, and I have 6 more wedges to do. I tried 6 wedges in total and it was not enough, so 8 wedges worked out a little bit better. Of course, you may find that yours will work out good with 6 wedges, or maybe you need 10 wedges. So now here I am. Every other needle is going to be a lace. Knit back to the right. I am going to put my row counter back to zeros. I'm taking the first. Now see, that one didn't really knit too well. And before I forget, I'm going to move my claw weights up. But you'll see it as you're working along. And now I'm going to knit back. So there's row one. Let me put the camera on the front view of this so you could see what's happening there. The end needle I transfer out. Bring the needle over here on the right to hold in position. One, now, don't look at this lace here, just look at this one. So I got that one, I want the next one. And like I said, it's every other needle. When you look at it, now this one may be a little bit better because we have the two there, so I have 1, 2, 3. Now I have the 3 gray needles here. I need to bind off those 3. Again, putting that last stitch on the end, left 15. But as I look at the lace, see, there's this one here, so I've got that one and that one that I need to transfer over. And because there's 3 stitches on that needle, I just bring it out and then put the stitches behind the open latch. And I guess it didn't work. I should have had my claw weight up here. Always the end needle, going every other one. Now I have 3 stitches to transfer over. One, two, three, four. Only to the 2, so I need to get that out again. This is where I have the 5 needles to transfer over. And as you see, the last lace is here. If I was to do this next one into holding position, it's not going to work. So this is where I bring those needles back. I knit two rows. I bind off these three stitches again. But this is where the last, because this is the last row of the wedge, I bring those needles out to hold. I bring all the left, I don't need to bring that last one over there on the right, just out to push those stitches, the latches open. I move the first one over, I put that back into holding position, and then I take the other six. Transfer them one over. I knit back, put my row counter back to zero, and start all over again. So I'm going to do this five more wedges. When you finish the last wedge, and I have it ready here that's having the every other needle eyelets, I'm going to knit across. And this is where I probably would be doing the, not probably, but this is where I would be bringing that first needle out to hold. But because this is the last wedge, I need to finish this off. I'm going to knit one more row. Then I am going to bring my needles out to the holding position, remove my claw weights. And I could work up waist yarn if I wanted to, but because I like to hand graft, you could machine graft if you want. You would work it off on waist yarn, turn it around, put the other first row back on, and then graft that way. But the way I like to hand graft is I will go ahead and I will take my knitting needle. Now when the purl side is facing me, I go through the first part of the loop. I have gone through the second part of the loop. It's a little bit easier putting it on that way. But when I go to graft, the stitch is twisted. So this way here, I don't have to worry about the stitch being twisted on the hand needle. I guess I gotta bring the needles back. And there, so I'm gonna cut a length of yarn and go hand graft this together, and then I'll have my two doilies. And then last, you have to close up that hole. Well, of course you can keep it if you want, but just take your tapestry needle and then go probably every second row. You don't have to go every row. And just slip through that outside stitch. All the way around. And if you happen to go the inside stitch, one stitch inside, that's no big deal. The only one that's going to know that is you. And as you see, the outside parts, the teeth there are curling on me. But once I get it wet and then roll it up dry, let it pin it out to my quilting thing there and let it dry, it'll be just like the blue one. So now I'm just going to take and pull that closed as best as I can. And because this is a doily, I could go ahead and knot the beginning and end yarn here. I would just do two overhand knots. And then I would take and weave the yarn in, probably one going this way and then one going the next one. And there we go.